हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द कंप्यूटर एडेड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज यूजिंग ऑटोडेस्क फ्यूजन 360. सो इन टुडेज फर्स्ट ट्यूटोरियल वी आर गोइंग टू क्रिएट दिस सिंपल पार्ट हैविंग द डायमेंशंस एज इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. ओके, एंड दीज आर द सिक्स होल्स, ओके, ऑफ 512 mm व्हिच वी हैव टू ड्रिल. एंड द thickness of the plate is, let's say, 20 mm, and the drills which we want to hole are not through holes, okay, they are at distance 15 mm, okay, deep. So let's get started with Fusion 360. This is the environment of Autodesk Fusion 360. You can get this software by showing your credentials as students, or if you are faculty, then Autodesk also provides a faculty registration by accepting the credentials from the respective institute which you belong. And it offers the education license for a 1 year, and subsequently it can be renewed, okay, after 1 year again showing the credentials. So the good part of the software is, okay, compared with some other softwares, the Fusion 360 doesn't entirely install all the features, okay, on the parent computer from which you are going to operate, okay, and it requires internet for storing the data, okay, although it installs the desktop version from the internet, so you don't really require any setup file. You just have to go to the website of the Autodesk, do the registration, and then there will be a link which will automatically download the software for your desktop or PC. And every time you are trying to save the content, okay, it is advisable to have internet so that the files which you have worked on can also be stored on the server of the Autodesk. And again, the beauty, if you change the location, okay, you don't have to carry the same PC everywhere. You just have to log into the Autodesk, okay, and you will be able to use all the files which you have worked so far. So that's the good part of the Fusion 360. Apart from that, it is all common things, okay, which are there. So we'll first create that part. So I have opened here design environment, okay, and in that I have given the file name as drill1. Now when you will start the file, a new file in a design environment, okay, or any file in that matter for any environment, the initial file name will be whatever name you give to the file, followed by v0, so that is a version 0 file. Now Autodesk also saves the different versions, so that and you can literally access all those versions from this window. So here you have various projects, okay, which you can create for yourself, and the file gets saved as different version file. So file name will be same, then followed by v0, v1, v2, v3, and so on. Depends how many editions you do on that file, that many number of versions the Autodesk is going to save. So it's fairly easy for us to retrieve the information, okay, and at this below this particular task bar, you can call it, or the activity bar, you can call it, okay, you can play the entire history the way you have created the model, okay, the way you have created the model. So that is also a good feature which is provided by Fusion 360. Apart from that, it provides all CAD/CAM CAE related features in the same software. So you don't have to go in different softwares for performing the CAE activity. So CAE activity basically involves the creation of the model, 3D model, then perhaps doing the simulation, okay, maybe in any environment, okay, fluid environment or structural environment. Then perhaps if you require to manufacture that part, you can go to manufacture. Okay, now manufacture also has two things, the subtractive manufacturing and additive manufacturing, and both the things are provided in this manufacturing tab, and both are excellent features. And then the last thing is drawing. So when you want to submit the final drawing for the manufacturing team to actually make the part, then you can do that in a drawing environment. So all the also if you want to publish something, okay, the part, then you can go into the rendering. It has excellent rendering features. And also if you want to showcase how the assemblies work, okay, that animation you can use and animate the assemblies, and that also you can showcase to the client. So there are excellent features provided, and this is the new feature which Autodesk has come up, and many softwares are now coming up with such a feature, which is called as a generative design. So it is a type of form design. So you form certain shapes and you keep on changing those shapes, and you try to achieve a can say intricate shapes without actually going into much of the mathematics of those shapes. So if I have to create a very intricate shape using a conventional way, then I will have to go into its details. Okay, so generative design, you can just pull the stuff, okay, and create the design. So that is a good part. So let's get started. We'll work with, let's say, we'll work for creating the part first. So I'll go into the create sketch. This is a design environment. Okay, this is create sketch. I will select the plane. Okay, and I will create the sketch. Okay, this is the dimension. So the sketch has dimension 120 by 60. Okay, 120 by 60. So I'll give dimensions accordingly. This is 120, and this has to be 60. Now, centrally located, it has 6 holes, starting from this first hole is at 20 mm and at the center. So I'll come here. So instead, what we will do is, instead of creating the trying to create holes through the sketch, okay, trying to create holes through the sketch, what we will do, we will actually use a hole wizard, okay, or the hole command which is provided by Autodesk, that helps us to find out certain properties in the manufacturing tab. Okay, so I'll just finish the sketch. I'll click on the extrude, and I'll just drag it below. So we want the plate thickness to be minus 20, since I consider the top plane of the part as Z0, okay, and I'm extruding this part in the downward direction with amount Z equal to minus 20. You can manually enter the value, or graphically you can pull the part in the downward direction. So this is the part. Now I have here hole wizard, okay, as you can see. It creates holes, so I will just click on this. Now it asks the plane selection, so I'll first select this plane. Okay, now it is going to ask me the references from either sides. Okay, so I'll click on this. So this reference is 20, okay, and this reference is 30. Okay, so you don't have to click on enter or something. Okay, as you enter the values, okay, you don't have to press the enter key. Okay, those values stay over there. Okay, then the type of hole. For a type of hole, you can just come here. Now, hole type is simple hole. Okay. कि ड्रिल पॉइंट इज फ्लैट. ओके, वी आर गोइंग टू ओनली ड्रिल द होल. नाउ द होल डायमीटर विच यू कैन स्पेसिफाई ओवर हियर एज दिस इज द डेप्थ, सॉरी दिस इज द डेप्थ. सो डेप्थ वी वॉन्ट एज 15 एंड दिस इज द होल डायमीटर विच इज 12. ओके, दैट यू कैन स्पेसिफाई ओवर हियर. सो नाउ एज यू कैन सी द होल has got its position. So it is 20 from the left edge and 30 from the top or bottom edge, which means it is at the center. Okay, and it is not a through hole. Okay, it is not a through hole. So few more parameters, as you can see the objects to cut. Just change these values. Yeah, and that will be it. Okay, so I'll just say okay over here. When I say okay, the hole automatically gets created. As you can see over here, the hole is created comfortably. Now the next thing that we will be doing is creating the remaining 5 holes. Okay, so for that I will require to select this thing and I will go to this rectangular pattern. Okay, I will go to this rectangular pattern and click on the directions. So this is the direction. I will require 5 such instances and the distance is going to be 16 each. So 16 5s are distance is 80. Okay, 16 5s are distance is 80. But in fact, okay, how many holes we want? We want total 6 holes. Okay, 6 holes. So the distance should be, I will say here, 6 holes. Okay, including the original hole. So the distance is 80 and total number of holes are 6. So once that is done, I'll say okay. Now we have 6 holes. So now we have created the geometry. Okay, now we have created the geometry. So if at this point of time, if you click save, okay, it will save it as version 2. Okay, user save. Yeah, sorry, version 1 it has saved. Okay, now I will move into the manufacture environment. So manufacturing workplace, I'll just click on this and as you can see we are in manufacturing workplace and here you can see the normal milling, turning. Then you have an additive tab where it works with the additive manufacturing environment as well. Inspection, then some fabrication also it works with. Okay, so sheet metal. So it has provided all the things in single software, which is an excellent thing. So what we are going to first do is we are going to go into the setup. Okay, we are going to go into the setup. First we'll be selecting the operation type. Okay, so the operation which will be before that we will select the machine and the machine library. Autodesk has excellent machine library, so you can go and see over here, that is Fusion 360, and it has got all the machines which we can select from. So since it is only drilling operation, so we can go ahead with 3-axis machine, or we can go ahead with this generic 5-axis machine. So it is the vendor Autodesk. It is a machine which they have created for this environment. Okay, and there are other machines, as I mentioned, the real machines which are basically provided by different manufacturers. So there is Haas machine, then Prusa machine for the additive purpose. Okay, Haas is also CNC. If I want to select typical category, then I can get this. Okay, so these are the various machines which are available. Of course, we will select this which we have already selected. Okay, I'll just click on select. Okay, and then machine gets selected. Okay, if you want, you can edit the machine also. Okay, the operation remains to be milling. Okay, the orientation, the model orientation is selected. Okay, origin, select box point, or you can say selected point, and accordingly you can select this point as the origin. Okay, so world coordinate system origin is selected. The next thing is defining the stock. Okay, so we'll come here. Now, do we want any additional stock, since we are only going to do a drilling operation? So we don't want any additional stock in any direction. Okay, so we don't want any additional stock. So stock side offset, and then stock top offset, and stock bottom offset, and round up the nearest. So you can select the stock accordingly. Now, normally in milling operation, we will want to have, let's say, stock side offset, so that we can have a good surface finish on the sides, and then perhaps stock top offset first, and then from the bottom, if we are trying to machine as well, then we will create it in a new setup. Okay, in a new setup. So this is a good option, and then a post process. Okay, we will be requiring to generate a CNC program, or you can say NC program, and for that purpose we will require a program number to begin with. So this is going to be the program number with which we can begin. Okay, and world coordinate offset, that is not required. So here you can say model origin. Okay, that would be the good thing to select. Okay, so model orientation we have selected, we have given the stock properties, and we have given the post processor setup properties, like the program number. Okay, if you want to give comment, you can give comments also here. Okay, drilling program. So I'll just say okay, and we have set up the machine. Okay, now what is required is, okay, the next thing that is required is for us to set up the operation. So as you can see here, the drilling operation tab is available. So I'll click on that. Okay, the first thing is selection of the tool. So I'll click on the select. Okay, this can take some time for the data to be loaded from the server. Okay, so here you can filter the data as per the hole making. Now the data which is being showed over here is a inch data, I guess. So we will select a sample tools metric data. Okay, and hole making is already selected, and in that I will select drill. Okay, the diameter which we want is 12 millimeter. Okay, so I have this 12 millimeter diameter drill. Okay, this drill I am going to select. Okay, and the cutting material, let it be say aluminium drilling. Okay, so how many cutting materials? We have these many types of cutting materials. So low carbon steel, high carbon steel, stainless steel, titanium drilling, copper drilling. So accordingly, the drill tool material will be selected. Okay, drill tool material will be selected. So that is also quite a handy information that we get over here. So I'll just select, assuming the material is aluminium. So I'll select this aluminium drilling. So once I select aluminium drilling, okay, I get all the corresponding spindle speeds over here. So spindle speed, surface speed, plunge feed rate, then feed per revolution, okay, retract feed rate, etc. So if you want, you can change these values. Okay, Autodesk will allow, or Fusion 360 will allow you to change the values, but these are the default values which are stored for this tool, okay, for this type of material. So that is quite handy. The coolant type can be flood type, mist type, through tool. Okay, since we are working with, let's say, drilling, you can switch on through tool, or you can also keep it as flood type coolant. Then in the next tab, these are the geometry tab, we are going to select the holes. So in sequence we are going to select the holes. So as you can see, I have selected 6 holes. Okay, now the order in which they can be drilled, okay, there are you can have your own selection. So then it will be order selected. Then otherwise the machine can optimize the tool path for you. Okay, the manner in which tool is going to move from one hole position to the other hole position. And the optimization means it will try to find out the shortest path possible. So if there are, say, patterns of holes to be drilled, okay, then the optimize order is a good option to have, because it slightly reduces the time. Okay, then there are other options: order inside out, order by X, order by Y. There are various other options. Okay, select same diameter, auto merge hole. So sometimes the requirement is that you don't have the exact diameter tool. So then in that case, select same diameter will help us. Okay, tool orientation. Okay, tool orientation. So it is Z axis. Okay, and the origin is set up world coordinate system. So we don't have to actually change anything over here, because we have already got the tool path for the drilling tool from this particular phase. The next is the height. Okay, this is a very important thing. Now retract height the clearance height is a retract height. Okay, retract height is basically calculated from stock top, and let this be 10 mm. I will increase the clearance height to, let's say, 20 mm to be on the safer side. Okay, then feed height, the plane above which the tool is going to go to the next location. So let's say it finished the first drill. Okay, come up and go to the next location. So that feed height is 5 mm. If you have obstacles in between, you can have this height adjusted. But if there are no obstacles, the 5 mm height is substantial. Okay, then top height is hole top. Okay, bottom height is hole bottom. So it is automatically get selected, since we've selected the entire extruded body, okay, which we created from the hole wizard. So the top height and bottom height is automatically selected as hole top and hole bottom, which is an excellent thing. Okay, so we don't have to do much over here. Then the cycle, as far as the cycle is concerned, it is drill rapid out. You can have, let's say, different kind of drilling possible, okay, which are mentioned over here. So it can be drill rapid out, Drill rapid out means what? We are going to drill the hole in a single pass and rapidly it is going to come up. Then go to the next position, drill the hole at the required feed rate, and then rapidly it is going to come up. That is what we mean by drill rapid out. Okay, then there are deep drilling, full retract, okay, breakthrough, then tapping, etc., etc. There are many such options, which is excellent. Okay, we can explore them in the coming lecture series. Okay, so I'll just say okay. This is a simple drilling exercise which we are doing right now. So I'll say okay. And now, as you can see, the tool gets mentioned over here along with the header. And yeah, this is the tool. And now we can actually simulate this environment which we have just set up. So how to simulate? Just right click over here. Here you will get the option for simulate. Click on simulate. I mean simulate the information that you can mention while simulating the activity. So you want tool to be shown, you want tool path, or if you want points to be shown, then you can activate it. Stock is shown, okay, and as you simulate, the removed stock will also be seen on the simulation environment. Then as far as the information, the positions of the tool, spindle speeds, etc., that you see over here, okay, how much is the time, okay, required, so 32 seconds, okay, something with the machine, okay, so it is generic 5-axis machine, and some of the statistics, the timings, okay, elapsed timings, distance covered, number of operations, number of tool changes. Okay, so I'll just play this. Okay, this is the speed with which it gets played, so I'll just reduce the speed. As you can see, and you can rotate the object while it is doing a drilling operation. You can zoom in, zoom out. Okay, that is how it is trying to do the drilling. So it's fairly accurate, and since I reduced the speed slightly, you can increase the speed. Yeah, so it has completed the drilling. Even though the time required is 32, we know that it is aluminium and the depth is also not that much, so time is calculated on the basis of the default feed rate and spindle speed rate and plunge rate values which are stored for the tool, and the total amount of distance that it has to cover. Okay, so it is not a long distance that it has to cover, and the depth is also very small, and the material is aluminium, so the machining time is considerably less. So how to go back to the same previous environment? You can just close this. So here we have set up the simple drilling operation. A simple drilling operation. Now the only thing remaining is we need to post process this. Okay, we need to post process this. So that is also possible from right clicking this drill operation, and you can go to post process. Okay, you can go to post process. So this particular post process window opens. Now here you can select, okay, let this configuration folder be same. Okay, you don't have to change anything over here. Then post configuration, okay, let this output folder be also same. Okay, yeah, the information sometimes take time to pop up, so as you can see, the machine that we are going to select, okay, these many machines are available. So Fanuc incremental, Fanuc turning, Fanuc with sub program. Okay, so I'm going to select normal Fanuc. Okay, so the code that we create will be accordingly created for different controllers. So this is a Fanuc controller. Likewise, there are many controllers. Okay, so there is Haas also, which is a pretty common apart from Fanuc. Then there are some other controllers. There is Siemens controller also. Yeah, Siemens CNumeric. Okay, so let it be Fanuc this time. Okay, the program name is already there, which we mentioned initially, and the program comment drilling program. Okay, the NC extension is going to be .nc. Okay, and open NC file in editor. So that thing we have switched on. So what you can do is the Autodesk also provides its own editor to view these .nc files. If you don't have that particular editor, any other normal editor will also open these files. I will just allow 3D arcs, etc., etc., optional stops, separate words with spaces. So this is showing how the program can be generated. So once I click on post, okay, the important things which to select are: in post configuration, you have to select the post processor configuration, okay, used to generate NC file. So that based on the controller. So type of controller basically you have to select over here. Okay, you don't have to change this configuration folder. Okay, let it be default. Okay, make sure you have a proper program number, and if you require any comments, you can write comments over here. Okay, and let the units be document units. Okay, and I will just say post. So it will ask you to save the program. So I will just save this program 1001-drilling. The extension is going to be NC. So I'll just save this. Now what Autodesk does is, okay, it again quickly runs the simulation without showing it to us, and it will directly open the editor, the Autodesk editor for NC files. Yeah, here it opens. And this is the program that we get. So as you can see, 01001 drilling program. Then machine, vendor, Autodesk, description of the machine, some of the tool details which are entered in a comment line. Then you have G90, G94, G17, G49, G40, G80. So we are all aware about these codes. So G17 is for the XY plane selection, G49 tool length compensation off, G40 tool cutter diameter compensation off, G80 cancellation of cant cycle, G90 is for the absolute mode of programming. Likewise, you have the codes mentioned, G21, G28. Now few codes may be different depending on the controller to controller. Okay, then drill 1, so T1 M06. So first tool is selected, spindle speed is selected, and spindle rotation is clockwise, that is M03. Then using G54 and M08, okay, we are going to go to the first location. So G43 is on, so tool length compensation in positive direction is on, and first hole location at 30 mm above the top plane is been set, and the offset value is taken from register 01. So this special character H is also used. Then rapidly it goes down to Z10. Okay, then G98, G81. So now what we are doing, we are using a drilling cant cycle on milling machine, So G98 is for the return to the initial level. G81 is a drilling cant cycle. We again specify the starting coordinates, that is X20, Y30. We specify the depth. Okay, so that depth is Z-15. Reference 5. Okay, so it comes up to the initial level 5. And the feed rate, that is 437 millimeters per minute. Okay, then what we do, we keep on changing the coordinates. Only X coordinates keep on changing. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There will be 5 coordinates. Okay, and the same drill will happen. And then we stop, we cancel the cant cycle. We move the tool up to Z30. Okay, we switch off the spindle. We take the tool back to the home position. Okay. and we end the program. Okay, we end the program. So that is how whatever codes we have studied in the CAD CAM syllabus. Okay, mostly all the codes match because most of the codes are from FANUC controller only. Okay, so this is a sample program for drilling, and it matches exactly as we have seen. So percent sign for the opening of the program, the comments stays in the round parenthesis, and the program ends with M30 and then percent sign. So I hope you have understood this. This was a simple exercise just to showcase how to set up the problem, how to first create the geometry using design of the Fusion 360, design modular of the Fusion 360, and then going into the manufacturing tab, setting up the model, setting up the stock, and how to carry out the drilling operation by selecting a specific tool and giving the parameters, and how to simulate the activity, and later how to post process the activity, and how to basically read through whatever the program has been generated, whether the program is correctly generated or not. So I hope you have understood this, and there will be more such very interesting content coming up on Fusion 360 and manufacturing workspace of Fusion 360. So I hope you have enjoyed this, and stay tuned for more such interesting content on CAM tutorials using Fusion 360. Thank you very much.